Danny Smith. I'm 69 years old. I live in Carson, California, and I have the X Factor. I'm so excited because, you know, I thought I would probably do okay, but I really didn't expect to totally to bring the house down like I did. I feel really excited about it. Not a lot you can do because you can't tell anyone, so I'll just walk around my house going. They believed in Santa because of my performance. Kelly Rowland started it, and I forgot the young girl's name who's sitting next to her. I will learn it in time. And then Simon said, okay, I believe.
Absence makes the heart grow fonder. But I know my heart couldn't love you anymore. And as sure as the sun comes up tomorrow, oh, crying time will start when you walk out the door.
Come on, sing with me.
Said it's crying time again, you're gonna leave me. I can see that far away look in your eyes. I can tell by the way you call me darling, that it won't be long before it's crying time.
Such a or set me free. You're under my spell, like a man in a trance. Set me free. Come on, somebody play something.
Just like you, including you. Thank you very much. comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane.
My name is Denny Smith. Every day of my life, I walk down the street, people go, hey, Santa, how you doing? A friend of mine said, don't you get tired of people calling you Santa? I said, I guess not. It'd be easy to shave and cut my hair.
Anybody see my baby? Lord, won't you bring her right back home to me?
Santa Claus, you've got three S's.
Almost 70. I'm a pastor.
Amen.
And I currently reside in Carson, California.
Oh, and there's a big kiss.
My wife's name is Angel. She's the sweetest person in the world. I've been pursuing this singing dream for more than 55 years.
Also known as Santa Claus, it's Denny Smith.
I heard someone say, oh, I've waited all my life for this. And I looked at him, I said, no, you haven't. I've waited all my life for this.
I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour until my love comes all around. I'm gonna take you, girl, and hold you. I'm gonna do all the things that I told you in the midnight hour. Oh, yes, I am. I'm gonna wait till the stars come out to see the twinkle in your eye. I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour. That's when my love begins to shine. Cause you're the only girl I know. In the midnight hour. Come on, stand to your feet, clap your hands, help me out. Yeah, I'm gonna wait till the midnight hour when there's nobody else around. I'm gonna take you, girl, and hold you. I'm gonna do all the things that I told you in the midnight hour.
Denny, I once again believe in Santa Claus. I love you!
Well, Santa just rocked the house, right? So again, I think Kelly's got a really difficult decision here. Is Kelly going to send Santa Claus home?
Kelly, are you going to be naughty or nice? What is your decision?
They love him.
I want to be in this competition. You think the people earlier worked hard, and I'm the hardest worker here. I want it the most, and I will work the hardest to be there at the end.
Kelly, I need a decision.
I know you do. I'm trying to give you one.
Santa, I'm gonna send you home.
What?
So sorry, Denny. Please give it up for Santa one more time.
Oh, I'm loving this.
We've brought, how many folks out here watch the TV show X Factor? Let's try that again. How many folks watch X Factor? from the TV show X Factor. How about a great big hand for Santa Claus? And Denny Brand is also going to be coming out.
How are you guys doing tonight? Man, these guys are terrific. Give the band a hand, will you? Do a song for you written by my very good friend Mr. Hoyt Axton. I sang this on the Jay Leno show. I'm gonna be on the Jay Leno show again next week. That's right, this lady said he went off the air last night. You're sharp, I can't fool this crowd. Take off, Danny.
Well, I've never been to Spain, but I kind of like the music. See the ladies all retain there, and they sure know how to use it. Ain't never gonna lose it, I can't refuse it. Feels so good, feels so good. Well, I've never been to England, but I kinda like the Beatles. And I drove out to Las Vegas, I broke down in needles. Oh, can't you feel it? It's so real, it's so good.
Oh,
Me too.
Thank you very much. We're going to slow it down. I'm old. I don't know if you follow me on Facebook. I just got out of the hospital yesterday. 2 years ago, I had heart surgery. It didn't work. So last week, I went back in the hospital. Got out Friday. Michael invited me to come out tonight. So I have to sing a slower one. This is by Buck Owens, Ray Charles, and Wayne Newton, called Crying Time. Bring my little brother up, Danny, again to help me with the harmony. Oh. Well, it's crying time again. You're gonna leave me. I can see that far away look in your eyes. Makes the heart grow fonder, but I know my heart couldn't love you anymore, and as sure as the sun comes up tomorrow, oh, crying time will start when you walk out the door. Come on, sing with me. Said it's crying time again. You're gonna leave me. I can see that far away look in your eyes. I can tell by the way you call me darling that it won't be long before it's crying time.
guys with us. We got time for one more this set.
I went down to the river, stood on the shore, looked like the devil.
My name is Denny Santa Claus Smith.
It means a lot for me to be here. You know, it's a lot of fun being around a lot of veterans who are very talented, and to take part in this and be able to sing in the choir with all these people, it's quite an honor.
Sending me angels to teach me to fly.
Vietnam was a brutal war. You didn't know who the enemy was. You see and you're involved in things that you can't forget, and it plays on your mind to this day. You shouldn't have to see things like that. And once you see them, you can't unsee them. And no matter how hard you try, those memories are still locked in the back of your mind. And sometimes they haunt you 50 years later.
And all the enemies that should have been friends, oh, here we come again.
Like a lot of people, not everyone, but like a lot of people who came back from Vietnam, we came back with a drug habit. It was a relief. I'm not making excuses and saying it's right. I'm just saying there was a lot of us who did that. And I just got tired of living that way. So I started playing music again right after the war. Music has always been a salvation for me to find peace and inner strength. My wife passed away in March of 2015, devastated me. And in New Mexico, my son had a massive stroke, and he never recovered. And 10 months later, he died, and I tell you, it was the most painful thing of my life. When my wife passed, I hated it. But it's nothing like losing a child. When you lose a child, it just sucks everything out of you. And I just covered up my head, laid in bed, and wanted to stay there. And then some friends of mine said, come on, you have to live again. Let's go play some music. So music came to my rescue again. And I am thankful I have discovered the Veterans Program to help through music therapy. I turned my life around, and I'm quite proud of that. And I'm learning a lot, so I'm going to take something away from this that I didn't expect to take.
Hi, this is Denny Santa Claus Smith with Hollywood Happenings, and I've been seeing a play tonight. It was a marvelous play. It was based on Cannibal and the Headhunters and their big hit, Land of a Thousand Dances, a song that wasn't doing that well, and then the Beatles invited them to be their opening act on their American tour. It changed their lives forever. This play is a great play with a great cast, a lot of great original music. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I believe you will, too, if you come to see it. It's from May the 5th today through May the 29th. It's Friday at 8 p.m. Saturday, they have a matinee at 3 and Saturday at 8 p.m. and Sunday at 5 p.m. Tickets are reasonably priced. I believe you'll have a good time. Thank you very much. Good day from Hollywood Happening. Smith for Hollywood Happenings, and I just happen to be in Hollywood tonight. I'm right on Colin Firth Star, and we were here to see Colin King. Now, you can call that an accident if you want to or not, but that's not what I'm doing here right now. Right now, I'm here because I met one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen. Hi, this is Denny Santa Claus Smith with Hollywood Happenings, and I'm actually in Hollywood tonight. I'm here at the Pig and Whistle, and I'm talking to
Carla Ashley.
And what is your title here, Carla?
I'm a music booking agent, and I'm a daytime manager, hospitality manager, and marketing manager here.
Dishwasher, cook.
Yeah, everything.
Everything.
Yeah.
And how long have you been here?
I've been here 3.5 years.
And are you planning to have music here once a week, twice a week?
Actually, for the last few years, I've been developing a live music showcase in the front room, often in conjunction with the Musicians Institute, which is right next door to us. And a lot of the administrators and students and alumni have graced us with their talents. And I also, you know, offer up the floor to international performers, national performers, and it's going really well. You know, we do this on weekday nights, and we always have a full room of music lovers, music professionals, and it's very inspiring. It's a beautiful historical location, and we also have, you know, we actually have in full 3 rooms to work with. We have the main dining room here where we just threw down tonight a great rockabilly show with Colin King and Shane Gray opening, a great blues presenter. And we've got the Sinners speakeasy downstairs. We've also got the backstage with Mike Giangreco, who's been in the business for a really long time. And, you know, we've got a lot of DJs, you know, presented by Michael Connor, who's my managing partner here. And the establishment is owned by Alan Hajar and Chris Breed. And they've been in the business for a really long time. The Pig and Whistle has been here since 1927.
1927.
That's right. This is where all the golden era stars celebrated after their premieres at the Egyptian Theater next door. We served as the concession. And a lot of people know that this is where Judy Garland celebrated her 15th birthday party when she was filming Wizard of Oz. Clark Gable and Howard Hughes and Barbara Stanwyck, they were known to come here. Shirley Temple, she drank Shirley Temple drinks here. You know, it's a really special relic on the boulevard. And now we are, you know, 7 nights a week, full-fledged entertainment venue, but along, as well as that, a restaurant that also is family-friendly.
Was the Shirley Temple invented here?
They say it was. There's all, you know, there's some, you know, conflicting, you know, opinions on that because Shirley Temple Black was, you know, I guess she grew up in the Bay Area. And so there was a bartender up there who said that it was invented up there. But you know what? Her red carpet premieres were right next door. And there's no doubt that she drank them in here.
Very good.
Very special.
Well, there you have it. You learned more about the Pig and Whistle tonight than I've known, and I've been in Hollywood for a long, long time. It's been a very interesting night here, listening to music, learning a little Hollywood history. And what kind of food do you serve here?
We have international cuisine, anything from American to British to Mexican and Italian. And we also have a bar menu, happy hour, Monday through Friday, 3 to 6 p.m. Just pay attention to pigandwhistlehollywood.com. There you'll find our calendar. And follow us on Facebook and Instagram, too. Lots of fun stuff goes down here. They say it's haunted. I always say that if it wasn't haunted when we got here, it definitely will be when we leave.
What's the price range of your food?
Anything from, you know, $4 to 25.
All right. So if you're looking for a place to go for good food at a reasonable price, great entertainment, and a beautiful atmosphere, well, I suggest that you come to the Pig and Whistle 7 nights a week. This is Denny Santa Claus Smith signing off for Hollywood Happenings, everything in Hollywood.
Thanks, Denny.
Thank you.
Those of you that don't know, this is our yearly bike drive. We get bikes for kids every Christmas. For every $50 we collect, a child will get a bike for Christmas. We did well last year, but we need to do a little better. So we got the big guns with us this year. We got Denny Santa Claus Smith. How many of you watch a TV show, X Factor? That's Denny Santa Claus Smith. And he's going to be helping us out tonight. And if you'd like a picture with Santa, get in the mood for the season. Once again, every penny goes to Bikes for Kids. So whatever you can help. Hey, Denny, come on back. Why don't you sing one with us? Let's get in the spirit of this thing.
Watch out, you better not cry, better not pout, I'm telling you why. I said, Santa Claus is coming to town, Santa Claus is coming to town, Santa Claus is coming to town. Well, I know if you've been sleeping, I know if you're awake, I know if you've been bad or good, something good. For goodness sakes, yeah. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. I said, Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Come on now, play something.
Right, this is
Denny Santa Claus Smith with Hollywood Happenings, and I'm here tonight with an Elton John fan. What's your name?
My name's Kelly Oakes.
Kelly, what's your favorite song by Elton John?
Probably Crocodile Rock.
Oh, I love that thing. What year did it come out?
Oh my gosh. Probably, yeah, I was going to say, probably before I was born, yeah.
Do you have another favorite?
I would say Candle in the Wind.
Oh, I like that.
Yes.
That meant a lot with Princess Diana.
It did, yeah.
You know, I tried to talk them into taking all these flowers and drying them and then selling them as, what do you call that when you have dried?
Potpourri.
Potpourri,
that's
yeah.
Right.
But the Queen was not interested.
Didn't want that little side, yeah.
Have you seen Elton John live?
No, this is my very first time. Some other people in our group has already seen him and Billy Joel together, but this is my first time seeing him.
Barbara, the camera person tonight, her friend went last night and said it's great.
I know. I have a friend that went last night too and said it was great. I can't wait.
Well, thank you very much. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
We're here at the Elton John concert, and I have some fans. What's your name?
Wendy.
Wendy, and you said
Jim.
Have you ever seen Elton John concert?
First time.
First year as well.
Okay, great. What's your favorite song?
It's got to be your song.
How about you, sir?
I'm going to go with the Tiny Dancer.
Oh, I love that. Good choices. What made you want to come and see it tonight?
Yeah. It's a great excuse for us to spend some time together.
Oh, I like that. Thank you very much. This is Denny Smith with Hollywood Happenings, Santa Claus. We're going to find some more people to talk to.
Thank you.
Say hi, because we sat with you at Rolling Stones.
Oh, you did?
Here
you are. Barbara, we've seen Elton John. Everybody had a great time.
Especially
Nancy.
Hi.
Say, I love Hollywood Happenings.
I love Hollywood Happenings.
I love Elton John.
I love Elton John.
I love Santa Claus.
I love Santa Claus.
What was your favorite song?
Rocket Man.
Oh, I love that song. I kind of feel like it. All right, this is Michelle.
Hello.
Michelle's a model. Yes.
Not at all.
You're not? Oh. What was your favorite song tonight?
I'm going to say Candle in the Wind because it reminded me of my mother.
Yeah.
Yes, I recorded for my mom.
He didn't do the Princess Diane part, though. He just
That's exactly the reference I told him.
Yeah, he just did the Marilyn Monroe. That's okay. Every boy growing up loved Marilyn Monroe. At least my age.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, I did too. I did too. I still love Marilyn.
Oh, yeah, everybody.
Yes, she's a real woman.
All right. Well, thank you very much for the interview.
Thank you.
And we'll see you at the next concert.
Yes, we'll see you at the next show.
All right. Alex, when's Guns N' Roses getting back together?
It's not happening, man. Slash is kind of a prick, you know what
I'm
saying?
Yeah, I know that. I've talked to him about that.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I asked everybody else, what was your favorite song?
It was Rocket Man, too, but if I had a second favorite, it's Tiny Dancer.
I love Tiny Dancer.
Yeah. And he played it so early, I was like, what's going on?
Yeah, but he's got so many hits. He could have played another three hours, and he would have had to hit it.
Yeah. I mean, it was great. It was a great overall experience.
All right. Well, thank you for the interview.
No, thank you.
Everybody back at the office is going to be very happy.
Awesome.
You guys did a great job.
Awesome.
Thank you. I'll see you at the next concert.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, we lost somebody, but...
Tyson, the chicken man.
Hey, Tyson.
Tyson.
Come over here, my Arkansas boy.
Chicken man.
Chicken man.
First of all, this is Tyson. Tyson, I love your hair.
Thank you.
I wish I had. I don't have any hair on the top.
But like, you're making it up, really.
I'd have to pull it up here like this. All right, Tyson, what was your favorite song?
Rocket Man, probably.
I think Rocket Man might be winning this one. Is this your first Elton John concert?
Second one.
Second one. Where did you go to the first one?
The Palladium.
And how long ago was that?
That was like 5 years ago.
Right? 5 years ago. He announced tonight he hadn't been in L.A. in what, 12 or 15 years?
No, he was in L.A.
Well, he forgot. I heard him wrong.
How long ago? Except for the Palladium.
Except for the Palladium.
Special show.
How Tyson rolls.
It's like a special one-off.
What's on your shirt here, Tyson?
It's a Salvador Dali.
like rap lyrics?
Forever.
Alexa. Oh, you know, right?
I have a few of his paintings.
But you know Forever?
Well, yeah, I like that.
The lyrics?
Yeah, well, I don't know that. I do know because you just showed me. Yeah.
Outcast.
Tyson's a very clever young man.
No, Outcast.
We've had a lot of fun here tonight. What did you want to say, Tyson?
No. I was just saying the song by Outcast, and I just saw him.
Oh, I like Outcast. Yeah.
But Elton John killed it.
Oh, he just slayed him.
Killed it.
Well, I've had a lot of fun here tonight. I met all these nice people that had fun. Even some of them saw me on X Factor. And I tell you what, there's no better fun than to go see live music. Don't stay at home, buy a ticket, and go out and see somebody live, okay? This is Denny Santa Claus Smith signing off for Hollywood Happenings. Barbara's over there on the camera. I want to thank her. Again, Karen in the office, Ray in the editing bay, and Hannah doing the promotion. And everybody at Hollywood Happenings, you all do a great job. You make me look great. I appreciate it. Good night until the next concert, by the way, which is next Friday at the Greek. It's going to be an exciting night. You should be there. It's some of the greatest guitar players in the world. Johnny Lang, Buddy Guy, Zakk Wylde, and the list goes on. It's a tribute to Jimi Hendrix. So I think they'll be playing a lot of Jimi Hendrix songs. If you don't have a ticket, I'm sorry, it's sold out. But I might have a few extra.
Oh, no,
I'm
saying. Santa Claus. Don't be sad.
Santa Claus, gotta pick it up.
Good night, guys. Thank you very much. Spirit, and I know you haven't had Thanksgiving yet, but
ready because Santa Claus is coming to town. And don't forget, I want all you beautiful ladies and some of you good-looking guys and some of you that, you know, are just average, like me. Take a photo with me tonight. Help buy a kid a bicycle. If you put money in here, just tell me, I want a photo, Santa. I'll be right there with you, all right? God bless you.
Who could say no to Santa?
I could point him out, but I'm not.
Hi, this is Tino with Music You Can See. We're at Winter NAMM, and I just ran into a really good friend of mine that I've known for many years, I think since 1984, Denny Smith. You've seen him not so long ago on The X Factor. Incredible vocalist. I would call you a blues vocalist. I don't know.
I sing all kinds of music. I do blues is the main thing, but that's why the sunglasses. I take them off when I do country music. And I do some classic rock, and I write a lot of my own songs. I do Christian music, so I want to be a blues, rock and roll, country and western Christian pop star.
Awesome. And it's possible.
Anything's possible.
Let's talk about your career. Originally you were from...
I'm originally from Texas. I was born and raised in Texas. Then I joined a traveling band. They just happened to go to Madison, Wisconsin, where I met my wife Angel, was married to her for 50 years until she passed away. In 1984, where I met you, we were running Angel's Casting, where we did mainly extra casting for major motion pictures, but we also did extra and principal casting for like foreign films, some TV shows, and smaller things like that.
And she had a casting office in Highland Park?
That's true. We were on York Boulevard there.
What brings you to NAMM? I know you're a member. You come here, you've been coming here every year?
I come every year, almost every year. This year I happened to be working for the press for Hollywood Happenings. I've been interviewing a lot of the people here. And then some people know me, so I also get interviewed. So now I'm on the opposite side. I'm being interviewed by one of my favorite people. And I love this guy behind the camera.
Casey.
Casey?
Yeah.
Oh, man. I know this is a new venture for him, and I wish you guys well. I hope you do very well with Music You Can See.
Hollywood Happenings. Talk a little bit about that. When's your next event?
Well, Hollywood Happenings is a job I do. I interview people. It's a lot of red carpet interviewing, major events. We do all kinds of things. So the next thing I am doing is I'm going to the Rock and Roll Fantasy Camp, and I will be interviewing people there.
So. And you've worked with them before as well.
I have worked with them before, that's true.
Nice.
I just interviewed Mark Hudson, a great guy, producer for many, many hit records. Now his daughter is writing and producing things. She wrote a big hit for Katy Perry.
Oh, wow.
Nominated
really?
For a Grammy. So.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I enjoy both sides of it.
Sure.
I enjoy interviewing people, and I still like to be in show business myself. And I just finished a job with the fabulous Chambers Brothers.
No, talk
yeah,
about
yeah.
that.
We did that at the Arcadia Blues Club.
Wow, Chambers were there.
Yeah, so what happens is my band comes up, I play a few songs, and then I bring up one of the Chambers Brothers, they do a couple of songs, and we sit down and we bring up Willie Chambers, he does a couple. Then we all join on stage for the Chambers Brothers. I've been unofficially made a Chambers Brother.
Wow, what an honor.
So we've got some jobs coming up in Las Vegas at some of the casinos there. And if it works out, we'll tour some other parts of the country.
Wow, I hope you guys play again, because I would like to see that.
Yeah.
And if you haven't been to Arcadia Blues Club in Arcadia, California, you've got to stop in there. The all national acts, you never know who you're going to see there when you walk in. Well, it's been a pleasure, Denny, as always. I'm glad to run into you. I'm glad you're doing well. You're still going, man.
I'm still going. I'm hanging in there. Thank you.
God bless you. Denny Thank Smith, you. Music You Can See, Winter NAMM.
I don't know.
Hi, this is Denny Santa Claus Smith with Hollywood Happenings, and we're at the NAMM show for 2017. I'm excited. Let's go inside and see what we can find.
Sanctuary. what's your name?
My name is Denny Santa Claus Smith.
So what are you going to sing?
I'm going to sing Stormy Monday Blues.
Love that song.
I love this song.
Too.
Good luck.
Have a little bit of mercy on me. Lord, won't you bring a right back home to me?
I'm so impressed. You took us there.
Christmas has just come early.
I appreciate it.
Santa Claus, you've got three yeses.
I am so excited. It feels like Christmas.
Song.
Thank you very much. This is Danny Smith with Hollywood Happenings, Santa Claus. We're going to find some more people to talk to. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay.
The song. I have to say hi, because we sat with you at Rolling Stones.
Oh, you did?
Yeah!
Barbara, we've seen Elton John. Everybody had a great time.
Especially Nancy.
Hi.
Say, I love Hollywood Happenings.
I love Hollywood Happenings.
I love Elton John.
I love Elton John.
I love Santa Claus.
I love Santa Claus.
What was your favorite song?
Rocket Man.
Oh, I love that song. I kind of feel like I'm all right, this is Michelle.
Hello.
Michelle's a model. Yes.
Not at all.
Oh, what, you look like. What was your favorite song tonight?
I'm going to say Candle in the Wind because it reminded me of my mother.
Yeah.
I recorded
for
my mom.
He didn't do the Princess Diane part, though.
That's exactly the reference I told him.
Yeah, he just did the Marilyn Monroe. But that's okay. Every boy growing up loved Marilyn Monroe. At least my age.
Oh, yeah.
I did too. I still love Marilyn.
Oh, yeah, everybody.
Yes. She's a real woman.
All right. Well, thank you very much for the interview.
Thank you.
And we'll see you at the next concert.
Yes, we'll see you at the next show.
All right. Alex, when's Guns N' Roses getting back together?
It's not happening, man. Slash is kind of a trick, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah, I know that. I've talked to him about that.
Yeah.
All right. Well, I ask everybody else, what was your favorite song?
It was Rocket Man 2, but if I had a second favorite, it's Tiny Dancer.
I love Tiny Dancer.
Yeah. And he played it so early, I was like, what's going on?
Yeah, but he's got so many hits. He could have played another 2 hours and he would have had to get at it.
Yeah. I mean, it was great. It was a great overall experience.
All right. Well, thank you for the interview.
No, thank you.
Everybody back at the office is going to be very happy.
Awesome.
You guys did a great job.
Awesome.
Thank you. I'll see you at the next concert.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, we lost somebody, but...
Tyson, the chicken man.
Hey, Tyson.
Tyson.
Come over here, my Arkansas boy.
Chicken man.
First of all, this is Tyson. Tyson, I love your hair.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank
man. You. I wish Rachel. I don't have any hair on top.
But like, you're making it up, really.
I'd have to pull it up here like this. All right, Tyson, what was your favorite song?
Rocket Man, probably.
Yeah. I think Rocket Man might be winning this race. Is this your first Elton John concert?
Second one.
Where did you go to the first one?
The Palladium.
And how long ago was that?
That was like 5 years ago.
He announced tonight he hadn't been in L.A. in, what, 12 or 15 years?
No, he was in L.A.
Forgot. I heard him wrong.
Except for the Palladium.
Special show. How Tyson rolls.
It's like a special one-off.
What's on your shirt here, Tyson?
It's a Salvador Dali. Rap lyrics?
Forever?
I like Salvador.
You know, right?
I have a few of his paintings.
But you know Forever?
Well, yeah, I like that.
The lyrics?
Yeah, well, I don't know that. I know because you just showed me.
Outcast.
Tyson's a very clever young man.
No, Outcast.
I've had a lot of fun here tonight. What did you want to say, Tyson?
No. I was just saying the song by Outkast, and I just saw him.
Oh, I like Outkast. Yeah.
But Elton John killed it.
Oh, he slayed him.
Killed it.
Well, I've had a lot of fun here tonight. I met all these nice people that had fun. Even some of them saw me on X Factor. And I tell you what, there's no better fun than to go see live music. Don't stay at home, buy a ticket, go out and see somebody live, okay? This is Denny Santa Claus Smith signing off for Hollywood Happenings. Barbara's over there on the camera. I want to thank her. Again, Karen in the office, Ray in the editing bay, and Hannah doing the promotion. And everybody at Hollywood Happenings, you all do a great job. You make me look great. I appreciate it. Good night until the next concert, by the way, which is next Friday at the Greek. It's going to be an exciting night. You should be there. It's some of the greatest guitar players in the world. Johnny Lang, Buddy Guy, Zakk Wylde, and the list goes on. It's a tribute to Jimi Hendrix. So I think they'll be playing a lot of Jimi Hendrix songs.
you don't have a ticket,
down
I'm sorry, it's sold out. Oh. But I might have a few extra.
Oh, no,
I'm
saying Santa Claus, don't be sad.
Santa Claus,
gotta
pick it up.
Good night, guys. Thank you very much.
Lord have mercy! Lord!
to me.